You're watching Local 4, home of ClickOnDetroit.com. WTIV Local 4 News at 5:30 starts now.
A home invasion turned hostage situation. Shots fired and a home catches fire. New tonight, neighbors hiding inside their homes tell their frightening stories to Local 4.
It all played out in Dearborn. You saw this story first last night at 11.
These are some long, agonizing hours. Neighbors waiting, afraid to leave their homes, but also afraid to stay inside their homes.
Well, tonight, neighbors who live through that ordeal tell their story to Local 4's Mark Santia.
One local family didn't get much sleep last night. That's because they were all forced to stay here in their basement for their own safety. Wrapping up dinner, the Termos family gets unexpected visitors at the door. It's police.
Yeah, yeah, they're knocking our doors. They told them, watch out, put us in the basement too, because the next door neighbors, there was somebody having hostage.
Mike's family is rushed downstairs into this basement by Dearborn police.
My mom and dad and my brother and my brother.
Above ground and next door, police say three men try robbing a husband and wife inside this Dearborn house. Two guys make a run for it. They're arrested. The wife escapes, but her husband is held hostage by a lone gunman who pulls the trigger, firing warning shots.
We're waiting until they catch them.
As the Termos family tries to close their eyes, suddenly chaos next door.
Yeah, police very good. They was very good, and they was treating everybody fine. And everybody good.
As the husband and robber fight, Dearborn SWAT attempts a daring rescue. The house bursts into flames. The husband is saved. SWAT officers have to jump from the second story window to safety. Everyone in the Termos family is okay. They're all safe. As for those two Dearborn police officers, they're going to be just fine. And right now, police have three men in custody. In Dearborn, I'm Mark Santia, Local 4.
All right, Mark. And meantime, those Dearborn police officers are being called heroes tonight. The two officers suffered the most severe injuries, but as Mark said, those officers are expected to make full recoveries. We're told the three men should face a judge by the end of this week.
Some local students have their lines memorized.